front. It's just like me. I feel so blue. And I fall so much in love with you.
A lot of promos, when we did concerts and or any kind of promo in print, they say Paul Revere and the Raiders holding off the British invasion single-handedly, because we were like the Minutemen of rock and roll because we had the outfits. And so Paul Revere was an American patriot, and then Paul Revere of the rock and roll genre, you know, he also sent a message to the kids. It all kind of came together and came into a groove, and yeah, and all the elements fell together, and it was just a magical time of music and groups. It was a golden era of rock band. Obviously, our hearts are still heavy because we lost our dear friend and mentor, Paul Revere, last year, October 4th, 2014. He was a great guy to work for. I owe him a great debt of gratitude, giving me one of the biggest breaks I've ever had in music by hiring me. We got 24 top 40 singles, we got 8 gold albums, we hold the world record for more television airings in the decade of the 60s than any other rock band in history, 750 television performances. Got to give credit where credit's due. The Wailers put it out a couple of years before the Kingsmen or the Raiders.
61.
In 61. It became kind of a legendary song in the Northwest at the dances because it was the dance circuit, right? And then we played it at the dances. The Kingsmen played it at the dances. We had to sometimes play it 2 or 3 times a night. It was just one of those songs that kids fell in love with and they wanted to hear a lot. So, obviously, it was time to record the song, and it just so happens that the Raiders and the Kingsmen recorded the song in the same week at the same recording studio. And just as far as stats go, the Raiders actually outsold the Kingsmen in the Northwest about 10-1. We sold like 350,000 copies of it in the Northwest with our recorded version in Northern California. But the Kingsmen got the national hit, because I guess the FBI got caught up in the deal.
They banned it in Boston.
Yeah, they banned it in Boston. All of a sudden, all the kids wanted to buy it to find out what's wrong with the lyrics. They must be saying something nasty. And that just put it over the top, and so that made it get the national fame.